Hi, and welcome to Trex Academy, where you can learn everything you need to know about building your deck project. I'm Devin, and I'm here with Lindsay, and in this video, we'll be covering how to frame for a multi-level deck change like we have right here. So let's start here at our highest level of the deck. You can tell this is also the largest section of the deck, and that's because this is going to be the entertainment section.
Makes sense.
It's built to have a lot of people, larger table, more chairs to support more people. So now we have that definition again. That's going to be that section. Then we can step down to this next section, and this will be the cooking area.
Okay.
We can have a grill right here, as well as a bar level height table. Smaller area, fewer people, but that would be the function of this area.
Okay.
Okay, and again, then we can step down. Even though we could have just continued the same height all the way down, I wanted that definition for the next level. Okay? So that last section of the deck, that ground level deck, is even smaller yet than this section. And that's because it's going to be a more intimate setting for fewer people with a fire feature and just some chairs surrounding that.
That sounds good.
Okay, so you kind of see then how different levels can dictate different utilities within the deck.
Yeah, definitely. And it creates more interest around the overall look of the deck.
Like aesthetic.
Too.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. It's a great look as well. Yeah, good point. Now that we've talked a little bit about the design process and the thinking behind why you would want a multi-level deck, let's talk about the actual execution of how to frame a multi-level deck.
Okay.
Okay. We'll start right here.
Now, Devin, I see that this deck is connected to our higher deck over here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, could we also potentially treat all three decks as freestanding decks, or do they need to be connected to each other?
Yeah, no. So actually, this is essentially a freestanding deck in its own. It's all supported by its own post.
Okay.
Same thing with that lower deck or that ground level, right? It's resting on the post.
Yep.
This is actually the only point where we have one of our decks attached to the other, but essentially this is three separate decks.
Okay.
Okay, so it's key to point out, you can see we've got our beam to post connection here.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing. This is just another beam to post connection that we've made.
Okay.
Either one of them is code approved, but in this case, instead of having to just dig a larger hole, pour a larger footing, instead, we can just use this beam hanger, which is more specifically an HUC 210-2Z.
Okay.
Say that five times fast.
Yeah, no thanks.
Okay, it's really pretty simple. The 210 is 2x10 material,
uh-huh.
which is what we're using for a beam. And then the additional two is two 2x10s for the beam, right? Now you can see that's what it's supposed to be made for, okay?
Okay, so because this lines up with the post, this guy right here is going to save us from digging an extra hole.
Exactly.
All right.
As opposed to the one on the front, we have that cantilever, so our post is actually set about 2 feet back from the beam for this middle deck.
Got it.
So can't do the same thing, but if it did line up, I would absolutely just use another one of these beam hangers.
Makes sense, yeah.
All right, so from here, I think we're ready to start installing the rest of our joists.
All right.
After we do that, I'll show you how we're going to transfer or how to step up from this middle deck to that higher deck, because mm-hmm. obviously that's a pretty large step there.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Let's get to work.
Sounds good.
Making sure that the bottom of that joist hanger is tight with the bottom of the joist. All right, we've got all of our joists installed.
Yep.
And now we're just going to address that transition that we have from this upper deck to our middle deck here.
Cool.
All right, so again, we've already talked about it a little bit. That transition from our middle deck to that upper deck is way too high by itself.
Yeah.
So what we've done is just framed up a simple box step. Not too tall, but now again, we have a safer transition from that middle to the upper deck.
Yeah.
The other cool thing is we won't need a step for that lower or ground level deck to our middle deck, and that stair height is going to be the same as the transition right here.
Nice.
All right.
Now, one thing, I noticed the spacing is different between the deck frame and our stair box here. Can you speak to that at all?
Yeah, good catch. So typically we've been doing 16 inch on center for our joist,
mm-hmm.
but when it comes to the box step, you need a little more support. So we're actually 12 inch on center when using Trex deck boards.
Okay.
Another thing to note, obviously we're planning a little ahead because I'm going to be installing this on top of the deck boards once I add some blocking for additional support. With an inch of deck board here and an inch of deck boards there, that transition height is still going to remain the same. Okay, I'm just going to set this down and slide that up against that rim joist. And I'm going to be setting back just the measurement of my Trex fascia away from that front rim joist. kind of see right there. Okay, so we talked about this a little bit before, but we had to do some things before we were ready to install our box step. Lindsay installed all of the support blocking that we need, because again, this is going to be a step. It's going to be a lot of traffic, so it needs to be supported correctly. The other thing that we've obviously done is installed all of those deck boards, so now we're ready for that box step. So to figure out how to measure this and how to cut this into two different sections, first thing you need to do is measure the distance from the top of the deck board on this deck to the top of our decking on our other deck, and that came to 10.5 inches. So from there, we'll just divide that in half, and that'll give us 5 1/4 from the top of our middle deck to the top of the finished step. As you can see, we'll have deck boards right there. So 5 1/4 from here to here, and then another 5 1/4 from there to there.
Is that distance dictated by code?
Yeah, it is, absolutely. Well, for one, you can't go under 4 inches.
Okay.
So that's really important to know. In most jurisdictions, again, you always have to check. And then the other big thing is they actually allow for some flexibility, which of course you want to be as close to perfection as possible, but it's nice to know that you can have a little flexibility. In our jurisdiction, that's 1/4 inch difference from one step to the next. To also give you kind of overview of how we're going to be setting this up, we'll have our two deck boards on top, just like the rest of our steps throughout the deck. And then we're going to have our fascia flush with the top with a spacer right here, and same thing right there. From here, we're going to go ahead and attach this. And as we're attaching this, there's two forces in play that we have to keep in mind. Number one, we don't want it sliding out as people step on it, right? So that's our lateral force. The other thing we have to think about, it's going to be this uplift or vertical force. Okay, so to deal with this, first thing we're going to do is slide this in. And then for that lateral force, we'll be using these 3-inch SDWS structural screws. So you're going to go through the back side of that box step and into the rim joist of that upper deck. You can see right here, I have a limited amount to fasten to. So I just need to make sure that as I'm doing this across, that I'm hitting into that rim joist. In our case, it's going to be about 1 inch down from the top of that box step.
Now I'm noticing kind of a bow in this, so it looks like it'll be hard to hold right up against the frame. Now we can both hold it because you've got one of us on each end, but do you have any other suggestions for?
Yeah, absolutely. So especially if you happen to be working alone, the main advice would be just start from one end and work your way to the other.
Okay.
Instead of trying to fight one direction and push the other, because you can see as we've been pushing it, kind of rocks. So we'll just start here, go to the middle, and then go to the very end. Okay, so then the other attachment, like I said, even with this connected firmly to that rim joist, we still have to worry about this vertical force. So to take care of that, we're gonna be using the 7-inch L brackets, or an L70, and then we'll be using SD connectors to fasten that. And then we'll just get these in our bays, and then with both of those connected, we'll have a really strong connection and a good transition from that middle deck the upper deck.
And do these have to be in a specific spot, or can they just be in any bay? What would you suggest?
Yeah, we'll pretty much do the same thing as we do for our structural screws. That'll be one on the end, one on the other end, and then one in the middle. Just the main thing that we want to focus on, though, is that we have an attachment to the inside of this step box, and also an attachment to that blocking that you installed, that structural blocking underneath those deck boards.
Okay. Yep.
All right, so let's go ahead and get started.
Cool.
We'll go ahead and push this up against here as tight as we can. I'm good down here.
Yep.
Okay. So I'll start here on the first one, and then I'll have you do the middle one and the one on the end.
Sounds good.
So we have our box step secured. The next thing we're going to do is just repeat this process to add a box step the length of our middle deck here. The big difference, though, is going to be that instead of being secured to the top of our deck like this, it'll be resting on concrete poured in a concrete forming tube and then attached using a bracket. So if you'd like to see more videos covering the entire deck building process, you can go to trex.com/academy. Thanks for watching.